Mute it so that we can start now. I think it was just a network error, which if it occurs, you log in and out again, and then you can get back to normal and get me. So now, let us just start. So today we are in the fourth topic, and in the fourth topic, we are going to discuss about cooking methods majorly. So when you get into the kitchen, what are those methods of cookery that you're going to apply? You will be given some food items. What are those food methods that you're going to apply inside that kitchen? So that is a brief overview of what is cooking methods. So you get to find that basically. Basically, we have to begin with methods of heat transfer. And when we talk about methods of heat transfer, this is how the heat from our gas ranges in our kitchen will get into contact with the food material or the liquid, whatever we are going to produce inside that kitchen. So that is what is termed as heat transfer. So in the kitchen, heat will be transferred into three basic methods. We normally have radiation, then we have conduction, and then we have convection as the three major methods of heat transfer. So now let's get a deeper perspective of what is radiation, conduction, and convection. So radiation is how heat is transmitted into short waves from this heat source directly to the surface of the food. So the way heat moves from the source of the heat to the food material that we are cooking. An example where we apply radiation in the kitchen is what is normally termed as broiling. That one is the process of radiation. And even grilling, when we grill meat kwa barbecue, kama venye mtura ufanywa, the process that which heat comes from the source of fire, which is the charcoal, electricity, etc., to those grills. Then when those grills become hot, they transfer that heat to our meat. That one is normally example of radiation. Besides that, whatever happens also in the oven, when we put our food item, that one can also be termed as radiation. Then we move to convection, and convection, food is heated or cooked in some form of liquid. So when that liquid, the water inside the liquid, rises in temperature from being cold, and now it goes up to being hot. That is the principle of convection, where the water will change from being cold to being hot, whereby the cold water will rise while the hot water will come downwards, because hot items are normally dense hot items. You are in it. It is the denser material that normally remains down, and as it acquires heat, it goes up. So the pro go round and round and round until the whole liquid will become hot. That is the process of convection. And then lastly, we have conduction, and conduction normally is a method of heat transfer in solid material. So when you put any solid material into a saucepan, sufuria. Then you turn it on. The process of that hot material to the process of that solid material, that is what is normally termed as conduction. So classification of cooking methods, and cooking methods are basically divided into two. It will either be a moist method of cooking, or it will be a dry method of cooking. Moist, that means we have some liquid being used to cook that material. While a dry method, it is just that food material that is present there. Cooking itself, we will add other things like oil into it, spices into it, to make it have some taste in the tail end. So moist cooking methods, you use a liquid, usually stock, water, milk, or fruit juice to conduct the cooking. In the next topic, we are coming to talk about what is a stock in place. So the methods that are involved in the moist method of cooking, we have blanching, boiling, poaching, steaming, braising, stewing as examples. So let us look into each and every method of cooking so that we can understand it further. So we start with blanching. And to blanch is normally a French term that normally means to whiten something. So when we blanch, we normally do have two types of blanching in the kitchen. Tuko na hot water blanching, then we have cold water blanching. And blanching is normally the process, basically we do it to vegetables. The process of immersing the vegetable in water, then you remove it. So hot water blanching, you normally find that you immerse that vegetable, the food material, into the hot water. Then you remove it. Unaiweka ndani hot water, unachemsha maji. Kisha kuwa moto, you take that food material, you put it there for some few minutes, maybe 2 minutes, then unatoa. After that, you go and refresh it. Kurefresh ni, now you take that food material ulikuwa umeka kwa maji moto ukatoa, unaipitisha kwa cold running water. So the reason why we normally do blanching is to retain color and also to prevent nutrients from overflowing kwenda. So you immerse it, then you immerse it in hot water for a few minutes, like 2 minutes, then you remove it, you go and put that food item in a tap of running to preserve its color and also to prevent it from overcooking. So the process of putting it into a tap of running water, the way inaitwa to refresh. Then we have cold water blanching, where unachukua maji, you put the vegetables, especially the fresh potatoes. Ukisha harvest your potatoes, those ones are normally known as the fresh potatoes. You normally, if you want to prepare them well, you normally put them in cold salty water, then unaziacha zinaiva hapo ndani. Hiyo ndio huwa inaitwa cold water blanching. Then we also have oil blanching. Unachukua mafuta kidogo, unaweka kwa moto, then you put vegetable, especially pepper. When I talk about pepper, nikina hoho, iwe hoho ya red, hoho ya yellow, ama hoho ya green. Ivo. Ama watu kona black pepper, white pepper, jikoni. They just make the food become more tastier. So blanching is the process of cooking a food item in water. It can be either in hot water or cold water. So nimesema hot water, sana sana watu unafanyia green vegetables. Spinach, skuma, unacha maji na kuwa moto na uneka chumvi ndani. Then you put it for 2 minutes, you remove. Then you refresh it under cold running water to retain the green color and also to prevent it from overcooking, ndio isipoteze nutrient. Then cold water blanching, unaweka tu kwa maji baridi na salt, then you let it boil. Sana sana watu unafanya kwa vegetable vegetables kama potatoes, fresh potatoes. Then we have oil blanching, which we do oil and some types of vegetable kama pepper. Reasons why we blanch: to brighten the commodity. So you want that vegetable to still remain sharp to the eyes of the customer. Then to remove some strong flavor. We also blanch to remove strong flavor from some vegetables, kama hoho. We blanch to increase the shelf life so that it can be durable. And then to remove the skin of some vegetables. Also, we blanch to remove the skin of some vegetables in the kitchen, kama nyanya. Nyanya kama utaki kupika na ngozi yake, we immerse them in hot water, itatoka. Then we also do it so to remove excess salt in bacon. So kwa mtu mwenye pendi salt mingi, you can also immerse it in water, then itatoa some salt, then you prepare for the customer. We move to the second method of moist cooking, which is boiling. And boiling, you just take the food item, you put it in some liquid like water, and then you let it cook for the required time. So boiling is the cooking in boiled water or any other water-based liquid like stock or milk. The boiling point is normally at 100 degrees centigrade. But remember, when you immerse something into water for it to boil, it will not reach 100 degrees centigrade because you will already have made the water impure. It is only water, your lake, at the sea level that water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. Examples of food that are normally suitable for boiling: tukona fish, we have vegetables, we have farinaceous dishes. A farinaceous dish is a dish made from the flour of farine. And example, we have pasta, kama spaghetti, noodles, macaroni. So food that can be good for boiling are fish, vegetables, pasta, eggs, meat, etc. So we just boil to incorporate a new flavor into the food. Or with something like meat, we have those tough meats that need to be boiled for them to be tender, due to sikule tapeworm. So advantages of boiling: older, tougher, cheaper cuts of meat and poultry can be made digestible. Number two, boiling is suitable for large scale cookery. Large scale cookery is when you cook for so many people. So you know, when you boil, uneka tu yo chakula pamoja, then you let it cook by itself. Then boiling is nutritious, well flavored, stock is produced. So it is a nutritious method of cooking, and the soup that normally comes out because this, let me just say right now, soup, because, or that liquid. The next topic is coming and we will address what is a stock, the nutritious fluid from bones or vegetable. So another advantage is that from boiling, it is nutritious, well, and a well-flavored stock will be obtained. Then boiling is simple and safe method of cookery. Then maximum color and nutritional value, especially in green vegetables, are normally retained when you boil. Disadvantages of boiling: there is a lot of soluble vitamins that is lost in the water. Boiling water with the lid on wears out a pot. So ukiboil maji na umefunika sufuria, huwa unafanya sufuria inazeeka haraka. Then cookery, then when you boil food, some foods may also look unattractive. But it is only unattractive if you don't know how to follow the points of boiling. Now, points of boiling, ndio hizo tumesema hapo. If you have vegetables, green vegetables, you do hot water blanching. If you have vegetables like fresh potatoes, you do cold water blanching. if you have vegetables that can have bitterness in them, kama hoho, do oil blanching, then that cook with them. So you must know what rules to put in place when you are boiling, and the food can always just come out moisture. The third method of moist cooking is poaching, and poaching is normally a form of boiling. But the difference between poaching and boiling is that poaching occurs at 93 to 96 degrees centigrade. But remember, boiling is at 100 degrees centigrade of water. So poaching are just some few degrees centigrade lower temp than that of boiling. So it is the process of gently simmering food in a liquid like water, stock, or wine. Examples of items that can be poached: we have eggs, we have poultry, fish, fruits, etc. So in a layman's language, it is just cooking below boiling temperatures, and it is normally 93 to 96 degrees centigrade. Advantages of boiling: no special equipment is needed, so it is just the saucepan, water or milk or wine, then we must the food material. So no special equipment is needed. Number two, quick, it is a quick method of cooking, and therefore it saves on fuel. Number three, poached food are easily digestible since no fat is normally added. Disadvantages of poaching: number one, poached food may not appeal to everybody, so it is not beautiful to this eye. Number two, food can be scorched if water evaporates due to careless monitoring. So that means if you decide to poach a food item, keep on checking whatever is being poached. If the water or the liquid gets over, the food item normally bursts, or it can even solidify, get spoiled. Number three, water-soluble nutrients can be leached into the water. Kitu kama mayai, mayai saa zingine ukrack. Then the nutritious part of the egg normally gets into the water that you will not even be able to drink. So when you poach, keep on monitoring the food item that you are preparing. The fourth method of moist cookery we have is steaming, and it is normally cooking by the use of steam. So food is cooked in a steam pot by boiling. So normally steaming, you normally take the saucepan, you put the food item, you cover it. So it will cook by itself by the use of the steam inside it. Advantages of steaming: number one, steam is a suitable method for vegetables because it will cook the vegetable very fast and prevents the nutrients from. Number two, steamed food are normally easily digestible because there are no fats that are normally added inside there. Then we normally have different types of steaming, and steaming basically normally comes into two methods. We normally have direct steaming, and then we have indirect steaming. Direct steaming So methods of steaming, you can either do a direct method or you can do indirect steaming. Direct steaming ndio kama ile yenye unafanyia mboga, for example, you take your saucepan, weka juu ya gas, then you put your cabbage and you cover it, but you remember to add salt. So that method by which heat just comes from the gas to the saucepan and directly to the vegetable, which now the cabbage. That one is normally known as direct steaming. Then we have indirect steaming, whereby you will have your food material, you immerse it kama ndani ya boiling water. So it is the water that is being heated directly by the heat. Then now the boiling water is what now heats the saucepan that has your food material. Hiyo ndio inaitwa indirect heating.
You are
So
currently the only
unachukua
person in
sufuria,
this
unaweka
conference.
na maji, ukisha we have eggs, not eggs. Yani, examples of materials that we normally bake, nimesema, we have bread, we have eggs, we have pastries, pies, tarts, cakes, etc. So bread tu ni mkate ya kawaida. Cakes, you know what is a cake. Pastries. Pastries hapa hivi ni any item that we will prepare by the use of flour, eggs, blueband, sugar. So hapa hivi ni kama cookies, ni kama queen cakes. They will require to be baked. Then tuko na pies, then tuko na tarts and cakes. A cake is just a type of bread that is normally cooked inside the kitchen. Acts of baking. It adds flavor into your food. Number two, foods that are normally baked are light and fluffy. Kitu fluffy, huwa ni kitu yenye inakaa kama sponge hivyo. Then certain foods can be prepared only by the method of baking. So that means ukitamani kitu kama keki, ukitamani kitu kama mkate, you just have to go through the baking process, and even buns are normally baked, and therefore flavor texture is normally very much improved. Then lastly, bake to your food items that you are eating. Disadvantages of baking, you require special item like oven, but kama una siku hizi tuko na other ways of how we bake. Tunatumia mchangarao uta bake, tunatumia mawe uta bake. People have become more innovative. The second disadvantage of baking skills are necessary to obtain a product with an ideal texture, flavor, and color. So basically you require those skills. You have to be taught how to bake, ndio utatoa the right item the way it is supposed to look like. Other thing, when you bake, you require monitoring it from time to time, or else your baking material might flop. Remember, tukibake pia huwa tunasema ushinde unafungua fungua oven. Once we introduce our temperatures into the oven, that's how our baking items normally flop. The other dry method of cooking we have is grilling, and grilling again is normally cooking by dry heat on grills. You cook on dry heat by the use of grills. So grills are normally those rods. Venye nyumbani mnafanya kuku, ukitaka ukishachinja kuku, ukitaka yale manyoya yake yote yaishe, huwa unaiweka juu ya. You find our mothers and grandmothers used to have some mesh material utaweka juu ya jiko ama hiyo the three stones, then now that's when they start to roast the chicken for the feathers to completely come out. So when you have a grill inside the house, or we normally call them grill bars, we call them rods or meshes, they are all used for grilling purposes. Methods of grilling, we're gonna grilling over heat, so direct heat hapo chini na umeka mesh yako ama grill yako hapo juu, then unachoma. Then tuko na grilling under the heat of sander. Salamander allergic. And one thing with the salamander is that it is normally connected to electricity to give us some heat in the kitchen. Sana sana it is inside the salamander that what tunaweka sahani na vikombe in the kitchen so that they can attain see nini atuweki sahani vikombe, but in the salamander huwa tunaweka maji so that ukisha pika chakula yako ikaiva unaichukua insert. Insert ni zile mazari kubwa kubwa zile za buffet zenye zinakuanga za chuma, and then you go and put it inside the salamander. So kazi ya salamander huwa ni isipoe. Ukila yako na waiter hajakuja kuchukua masa za lunch hazijafika, you go and put it on the salamander so that the heat, the right temp, the food can maintain its right temp. So again, we normally put our food items at the salamander. It releases heat, so it can also be able to cook our food items like tomato, bacon, and some types of fish. Then we have grilling between heat. And grilling between heat is when food is cooked between two electrical grill bus. Food is being cooked between two electrical grill bus. Ndiyo kama venye watu na toast mkate. Ukieka mkate kwa toaster, iko between two grill bus. So juu inaiva at the same time chini. That one is also another method of grilling. Then we move to broiling, and it is cooking by direct heat from a gas flame or electricity or coal. So broiling na grilling is one and the same. The principle behind broiling and grilling is one and between them at all. And you will find some people saying boiling the same. Dry heat methods using fat. Number one we have is sauteing. To saute in the, and ukisikia mtu amekwambia can you saute this food, and mostly we saute vegetables, huwa unachukua sufuria unaweka mafuta kidogo na salt ama pepper. Ukisha kuwa moto, unachukua mboga yenye ulikuwa umeprepare unaweka ndani, unakoroga according to the required minutes ulikuwa unataka, it is ready. So it is a method of cooking food with a small amount of oil. Na what tunasema, ukishake the vegetable into the oil, you normally wait the vegetable to jump. Ikiruka tu, if a few of them just jump, it normally denotes that it is already ready. Then it's normally that's sauteing. Rules to be considered when you are sauteing: you have to preheat the pan, then you let the oil become hot. Remember not to overcrowd where the oil is, because you people can get burnt. But you take necessary measures. Again, usitupe chakula ndani ya oil, we can even get burnt further. So you just put the food more carefully into the hot oil. The second method we have is frying. And frying, again, we use hot fat to fry. We have around three types of frying. We can stir frying, we can shallow fat frying, and we have deep fat frying. So frying is a technique whereby we put some amount of oil into the saucepan, then we can be able to cook our different type of food items. Stir frying as a method of frying, a small amount of cooking oil is normally poured into the pan, and here we normally have a special type of pan that is normally known as a wok. W-O-K. It is a Japanese type of pan. And garlic into it. Then you let it cook. Add ginger na garlic on food, huwa unafanya hiyo pan inakuwa sticky. So immediately take the food item, come even get burnt. So you find that most chefs, when they are doing stuff, they must have some liquor. Add some wine, they can add some spice to prevent the food item from sticking to them. Then we have shallow fat frying as another method of frying. With this one, you normally put some little amount of oil into them, then you cook the food material. Ni kama venye watu napika pancake, unachukua mafuta kidogo weka kwa pan, then unakuja yake cake. Ikiwa hiyo side unageu hivyo hivyo. It is also the same way ukitai, you will do it in the same way. Eats of short frying, you cook with some little amount of inside there. But si kidogo sana, unaeka mafuta vizuri. Then we have deep fat frying as another method of put a lot of oil into the saucepan. Then you let it, and once we deep
You are currently the only person in this conference. You are currently the only person in this conference.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, I cannot hear you.
Okay. So I was talking about stir frying, and I said that it is a method of cooking food whereby you put oil. After putting oil, you add ginger and garlic, then you put the food item into it. But you take reasonable care in that whenever you add ginger and garlic to your saucepan and you continue stirring your food item, it normally becomes stickier. So you have to make sure stirring that food so that it does not burn there. Saucepan. Then stir fry, you put small of oil. After putting a small amount of oil, you put the food item on it, and basically it just normally browns. So shallow fat frying, basically we do it to pancakes, edges, the fried eggs. That small amount of oil that you put for cooking that food item is what is normally termed as shallow fat frying. Then deep fat frying, this is when you put a lot of oil into your saucepan, then you are going to immerse your food item. After the oil has become hot, you immerse your food item into the hot oil. And remember, when you are deep fat frying, the food item that you want to immerse into the oil must be completely submerged into the oil. So we deep fry fish, mandazi, etc. Ata viazi, we deep fry. But remember, when you are frying, the oil must be hot. When you are putting the item that you unalepole, ndiyo mafuta isimwagike chini kuchome. Then ikisha iva, uwa unacha hiyo mafuta inakuwa tena moto. You leave the oil to reheat again. Then that's when you add another food item into the saucepan. Ndiyo tena yendele kudip fry in place. From there, we have talked about deep fat frying, where you wait the oil to become hot, then you completely submerge your food into the oil. Then we have pan frying, and pan frying, you take your food, also another form of frying, but now you put half way, then you will go and finish it with another method of cookery. Give 100% as pan fry. Basically, we do pan frying to become nyama, just make loose the nutritional value in it. Unaiweka kwa mafuta kwanza, then browns and it does not lose nutritional material from it, then that is when you go back and start cooking it the normal way, the way we know of cookery. And even what you can prepare by the different types of cookery. Then there is normally something known as herbs, spices, and condiments. So a condiment is any substance that you add to your food so that the flavor may be improved. So can be added in the kitchen when you are cooking, be added at the table when the guest is dining. Examples of condiments that we have in the kitchen, we have salt, we have mustard, we have pepper, and we have vinegar. Any item that you will add to food to give it flavor is termed as a condiment. So salt, tunajua vizuri, where we know very well, salt is sodium chloride, very important element when it comes to stabilizing the body fluids. Salt has so many uses, like preserving food with to eat. When you have salt, cool, dry container so that it does not become wet. Remember, chemistry was saying salt is some types of salt, hypopic, what effervescence, whatever is a salt. So when you have salt, do not leave it in a piece of paper, but keep it in a cool, cold, tight container so that it does absorb moisture. We have mustard. It's also another element in the kitchen. And mustard normally is picked from that plant that is normally known as the mustard plant. It is picked from the seeds of the mustard plant. Mustard as a condiment is not in the mustard, is the normally the most common type of mustard in the kitchen, and it is normally yellow in color. You know, it as often as the kitchen. And it has a milder taste in the kitchen, but all mustards are of food. Then we have pepper as also another condiment in the kitchen. And pepper, it's the home of pepper is Asia, because ni Wahindi wanapenda pilipili. When you say are sold, you will find that you will buy two types of pepper. It is all white pepper. It's normally known as pepper nigrum. But get a little seed. Zikauke kabisa mpaka zikue, get the pepper is the white pepper. Ni kali sana kuliko the white pepper. Condiment pia huwa iko hapo jikoni, in the pepper category one, kitu inaitwa cayenne. And cayenne pepper pia tu ni pilipili hoho ya red. Green na yellow, and paprika, and paprika is normally a Spanish pepper. Paprika is a Spanish pepper, used in the kitchen, sana sana tunatumia kupika nayo beef goulash. So it is also another pepper. Apart from cayenne pepper, tuko pia na paprika. Hizo tu ni pilipili tuko nazo jikoni. Then lastly, under condiment we have is vinegar. And vinegar is basically acetic acid. And vinegar will be used for so many things in the kitchen, to make vinaigrette sauce. It will be used for cooking so that we can have that sour taste in food, etc. Then we have spices, herbs. And herbs are leaves, stems, or flowers of plants, and are available fresh or dried. So it is normally used for cooking, but when you cook with it, it will either come as a leaf, a stem, a flower, ndio utaeka kwa chakula hapo kutumia kupika. They are used to garnish various dishes in the kitchen. Could garnish is to decorate dishes in the kitchen. They are used to enhance flavor and aroma of food. They are used to disguise unpleasant smell of food. Could disguise ni kuficha. Ndio kama chakula inanuka vibaya, usisikia harufu. Examples of herbs in the kitchen, tuko na dania, tuko na angelica, tuko na rosemary, tuko na tarragon, mint. There are so many. So when you will be cooking, you will come into contact with celery, leek, hiyo dania nimesema, parsley, bay leaves, anything that will be brought for cooking in the kitchen that will be leaf, stemmy, or flowery in nature will be termed as a herb. But isikuwe mboga. Then we have spices. There are they are aromatic vegetable products obtained from roots, stems, barks, and buds, flowers, and fruits of plant. So you normally find that most spices zinakuanga in powder form, ni zimesagwa. So ukikausha a herb, then usage, it becomes a spice. So it can be a root of a plant, kitu kama ginger, ikauke, ugonge gonge, it will become ginger spice. It can be stems, it can be flower buds, etc. Ikikauka, ikikuwa powder kama pilau masala, it turns out to be a spice. When it is fresh is when it is termed as a herb. Classification of spices. We have hot spices, examples of hot spices, they tuko na ginger, mixed spices, etc. We have mild spices kama cumin. Then we have aromatic spices. They just bring good smell of food kama cinnamon and nutmeg as examples. So kindly get to know more spices and more herbs that are used in the kitchen. Usually inaweza kuja you name 5 and you only know 3 from the notes. So kindly get to know more spices and herbs that are normally used during food production in the kitchen. So assignment tena iko leo, you describe the storage of herbs and spices. Nimemaliza. Are you there?
Yes, I'm here. Okay, what I haven't understood well is the method of cooking ilolisamanitwa poaching.
Huh?
Poaching ndo. Yeah, poaching, yeah.
Poaching nilisema it is cooking below boiling degrees. So water boils at 100 degrees centigrade. But when we poach between 93 to 96 degrees centigrade. Nikasema examples of food items ni kama fish na hata eggs. So tuseme uko nyumbani unataka kupoach mayai. You unaiweka mpaka hiyo maji kikaribia kuboil, you normally reduce the source of heat. Inakuwa kidogo ndio hiyo maji isi boil. Hiyo maji ki boil tu, you term it as a boiled egg. So it is just cooking below boiling temperatures, 93 to 96 degrees centigrade. Are we together?
Yes, you're together.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I'm clear now.
Aya, na assignment yangu.
Assignment gani?
Last week.
Oh, I didn't get the assignment. Sikujua na iko wapi, sikuelewa. Hata nilikuuliza.
But I replied your email. Nilikwambia the last part of your notes nilipeana last week. Hapo chini ndio hizo maswali zilikuwa hapo chini ndio nilikuuliza tu moja.
Oh, sawa, hata nitazianza zote saa hizi.
Haya.
Sawa. Nazianza kwa chat ama?
Hapana, you were supposed to do an email. In fact, it was one question. It was one question. Nilikuuliza swali gani? There's a question I asked you, so you were just supposed to get back to me immediately.
Oh.
Do you remember the question I asked?
No, I don't remember.
Even me, let me check first my email. You nilikujibu na email saizo. Let me see.
Oh, okay.
You are currently the only person in this conference.